Citizens Online is a UK-wide independent charity focused on the issues of digital participation. We've been around since year 2000 and have worked in communities for 9 years, and our funding comes largely through corporate donations and consultancy work.
The charity has three main activities. Firstly, we lobby and campaign for digital inclusion. We are proud of our contribution towards changing the landscape of digital participation over the last 10 years, and of our continued thought leadership on the details. We also deliver consultancy work with all profits pledged back to the work of the charity. We've worked for the European Commission, local authorities and CLG, and we've had repeat business for many of our clients, including BT, Bechtel, TalkTalk and the Welsh Assembly Government. Our Chief Executive is one of 7 digital inclusion advisors. Finally, we deliver projects at the grassroots, and our major programme, Everybody Online, has run in 23 locations across the UK since 2002.
My role at the City of London is as Deputy Town Clerk. In essence, my role's about improving efficiency and looking for ways in which we can continue to improve frontline delivery of services to our customers. This actually fits in very nicely with my role as project sponsor for the Community ICT project, because that's all about improving the life chances of people in our vulnerable parts of the city in the Port Soken area.
I like coming to this class because all my friends are here, the people who live on my estate. When we come here, you know, it's like a little women's group.
I think efforts like this to break down barriers are crucial, and I think that, you know, the traditional methods of getting people into adult or formal education just wouldn't work in a situation like this. You've got to come to them. These people won't go to a class. A lot of them won't fill out a form.
ICT skills for this particular group are just as important as English language classes. The thing that both English language classes and ICT does is make people more confident within the community, the wider community that they're living in. It also has raised the status of the women within their homes, their families. You know, they are now using a computer. Their kids obviously use computers, and their children are just so impressed with what they're able to do and what they've learned in a very short space of time.
We've got a partnership between the public sector, i.e. ourselves, the City of London Corporation, the private sector including BT, and the third sector including Citizens Online. But the real key to the success of the project has been our coordinator, Liam, meeting and engaging with people and helping them to use technology to improve their life skills and chances.
I met James at Middle Street, which is a hostel for former rough sleepers in the city, and James had never really touched a computer before. He had some really kind of like basic mouse skills.
Shall I find you a better sound? It is a bit sort of Pet Shop Boys.
You know, he could barely switch a computer on and just click. But since then, he's kind of learnt Microsoft Word, he's learnt how to do CVs, he's got an email address, and he's actually just secured employment using IT skills.
I had my own business, and I went bankrupt, and it was because of I was too heavily involved in drugs, and it was costing a lot of money to kind of run a business and keep a habit and stuff. And I eventually kind of I ran it into the ground.
I ended up getting sentenced to 4 years from this area. Had I not been using drugs, I wouldn't have actually been in prison, because when I started out in life, I had great opportunities. I walked into a golden job with my father. I had great ambition, and all of a sudden, it's like as if that was all a dream. Like, all the confidence you think you have when you're using drugs, when you take that kind of drug away, it's like as if you kind of become a bundle of nerves. And I had literally no confidence at all. I didn't really want to talk to people. So with Liam is such a kind of an easygoing person. He's very approachable. It was absolutely fabulous, like a reinitiation into life. Like, it was really fantastic, and I have great respect for Liam.
Yeah, that's internet.
Yeah,
we're connected. That's magic.
We're running an intergenerational project with Liam. It's several ideas behind it, one of which is to break down the barriers between younger and older people. So what we're getting them to do is to interview each other, to create films which will go onto YouTube. And those interviews can be about a range of topics, but we're also covering online safety, economic crime issues, child protection, things like that. And the idea is they'll make these films, produce them on YouTube, but also at the same time, without really realising it necessarily, we'll break down some of the barriers, which mean that sometimes older people perceive that young people are behaving in an antisocial way when actually they're just being young people.
Can you remember your daughter's postcode in Italy?
N-O-V.
What you can do, you can get this little chap here,
yeah,
and you can drag him somewhere onto the map and watch what happens. We're going into street view mode now, so now we're actually on the street.
Yeah, well, that's right. Well, then Susan's apartment's round just the by the green there. Oh, naughty. Well, you can see it. Golly, I could even see it.
I'd really recommend this project to other local authorities. We developed a toolkit, and this should actually help in terms of the lessons learned and practical steps of what you can do in terms of delivering this kind of success within the community.
At the start of an Everybody Online project, the community is audited so that the steering group understands the local assets and issues. A launch event helps to garner support and buy-in. The project is constantly monitored so that outputs can be logged and independent evaluations measure changes in the community. We have helped over 100,000 people go onto the internet for the first time, and more than 7 out of 10 of those people committed to encouraging their family and friends to go online, and 8 out of 10 reported an increased sense of belonging to their community. We have also supported nearly 200 people into work and recruited 500 volunteers. This graph shows the increase in internet use in project areas compared to national figures. They show that Everybody Online has made a significant impact on internet take-up, on average double that of the national figures.
The processes, toolkits and practice of delivering Everybody Online are all being captured in a product called Everybody Online in a Box, sponsored by BT and the Digital Inclusion team. Materials include building a business case for a project, getting started and setting objectives, PR and marketing, recruiting and managing volunteers, running events, monitoring the project and many other materials. This vast body makes scale-up all the more easy. Our experience lies in establishing projects in non-formal settings. It's important to note that over 20% of the most digitally and socially excluded areas don't have an online centre, and of those that do, 55% are libraries, which often will not attract the most socially excluded through their doors. So despite the great efforts of UK online centres and libraries, there is still much more work needed in the most disadvantaged communities. We propose to use an available mapping tool to map over 50 digitally and socially deprived communities in the UK. We could then offer a franchise model to the local strategic partnership and devolved equivalent, with part funding in place which might come from a corporate sponsor, Ofcom or the Big Lottery Fund. Working with the LSP, it's then possible to audit the area using community maps and develop a business case for the project. Further tools can help to define the programme so that it fits to the strategic needs of the area. Partners such as yourself can make use of this on-the-ground resource to deliver your aspects of the digital participation agenda. From McDonald's to the post office, libraries to Start Here, Age UK to Online Basics, Recycling, Meganexis, Looking Local and more, Everybody Online can offer a local resource to help realise your programme. How could you make use of this resource? How could we work together?